Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Check It Out, the library talk show that lets you know what's happening in and around the Bethel Park Public Library. We're your hosts, Elaine Volpe
and Christine McIntosh, and
we should say Happy New Year to everyone because we're a little behind on our taping. Here we are at the end of January already.
Yes.
So we'll be talking about February happenings. But yes, Happy New Year, because we have not seen you since the holidays.
Right. With our great holiday special, which I really loved.
I really liked it too. You know, Jimmy was disappointed in it. I thought you guys were fabulous.
I had a great time.
I loved it. And I'm already looking forward to next year.
Yes,
I have
me too.
The wheels turning. I have
you
an
do.
Idea I want to share with you.
Okay,
yes.
Awesome. we just had a big snowstorm, so that's why I have my hat on.
It's adorable. I love it.
I love my hat, my cat hat. My cats don't like it very much. They kind of look at me funny when I wear it.
Do they try to nip and grab it?
No.
No.
No. They just like...
Because I know a lot of times they sleep with you and they're up by your head. So well, not that you would have your hat on in bed.
I would hope not.
But I'm only asking because Bean still loves to, no matter what I'm wearing, like today it was my scarf. He's like tugging at it or...
Yeah. Well, he's a dog. He's not as cool as a cat.
Are dogs different than cats?
Oh my gosh. Yes, Elaine.
But cats are still really playful, I thought.
They are. They are, but not like differently than a dog. This is Elaine's first pet.
I'm still learning.
Yes, Elaine's first pet.
Do you know, I want to give a shout out to our friend Denise Pazukanix. She told me about the Rover app, and I think it's going to be a lifesaver. I've not used it yet.
What is Rover?
Well, you like dog sitters, dog walkers.
Oh.
So it's just, you know, it's a lot for him to be home all day with my mom.
Yeah.
Right, especially because he's so high energy. She just can't do it. And it's hard because Robert and I are both working.
Right.
So... I messaged a couple people on the Rover app today to just come and walk him for a while.
That's
so
awesome.
If you do not know about the Rover app, there's a couple different ones, but I downloaded Rover. Wonderful if you were looking for a pet sitter or just a pet helper outer, right? Like they'll come to your home and do visits. It's just...
That's really cool.
It's a cool resource. Yes.
So, well, it is winter, so we have the Adult Winter Reading Club, which will begin on January 31st and run through February 27th. So you can submit entries online or at the library. So for every book you read or listen to, no newspapers, no magazines, you'll fill out an entry form either in person or online. And then each week, one winner will be randomly drawn for a $25 gift card. And our grand prize this year is a Polaroid instant camera.
Fun! We have the best grand prizes, I think.
Last year we did that, it was a portable record player.
Oh.
Record player that looked like, it's a Victrola, which now is doing like, they look like a little suitcase, like we used to have at school. Remember the ones?
Yes, yes.
So we're trying, I don't know, we just...
So this year it's a camera, I love it.
A Polaroid, how long has it been?
Nice.
So come on in, sign up. And we have a few programs. Now, every year, Rob shows the Groundhog Day movie on Groundhog Day on a loop repeatedly all day. So that's Wednesday, February 2nd, starting at 1 o'clock. I think there's something in the fireplace room earlier in the morning. We have 5 things to know about writing and publishing nonfiction on Thursday, February 3rd at 6:30 p.m. This is presented by Corey Wamsley, who's the CEO of Aurora Corialis Publishing. So the first thing you need to consider when you want to write, the key ingredients to hooking your audience, and the biggest mistakes nonfiction authors make will be discussed at this seminar. So Thursday, February 3rd at 6:30. Then after shoveling all the snow that we've had to shovel, we have a seminar on shoulder pain on Wednesday, February 16th at 2 p.m., presented by Martine Marino. She's a physical therapist. So this lecture will cover common causes of shoulder pain and tips to treat and prevent pain.
I will definitely be attending that
class.
Yeah, what time, what day is
that? That is Wednesday, February 16th at 2 in the afternoon. So take your lunch.
Okay. Doesn't list any like of the popular causes or common causes.
She'll talk about the common causes, doesn't list them.
You know, my sister once told me it might just be like, she asked me which side I carry my purse on.
Yep.
Because I often have really bad shoulder pain on my left side.
Yes.
And I think that could be it or just like,
yes.
I don't know.
Depends on how heavy you got to clean out your purse.
Yeah, true. Too many books in there.
Yeah, that's
the problem.
I had a neck injury years ago, and I was going to a myotherapist that does like trigger point therapy, and that's what he told me to. He told me to use a backpack so that it's
evenly distributed.
And I still use. I didn't listen, and yeah. We our weekly clubs are meeting. So we have new movie release Tuesdays, every Tuesday at 10 a.m. in the fireplace room. And we try to watch the newest DVD release. However, there's not been a lot of new DVDs being released. So you never know. You never know what's going to be shown.
Have you seen the movie Encanto?
I have not, but it looks so good.
Oh, I saw it on Saturday and I loved it. It was a great, yeah.
I'll have to check it out.
Definitely.
Scrabble Club meets every Tuesday at 1 p.m. for fun, friendly games. I saw you recently finally beat your mother at Scrabble.
Yeah, after all these years, I'm talking years, that went down in the books. Like, I recorded it and everything, that I actually beat
I've
her.
I've only beat my mother once.
Yeah. So I've what is it? Our moms are just very...
I don't know, because neither of our moms are college educated, right?
No,
I
mean, but my mother is very, you know...
My mom, is a crossword person. She reads constantly, so she has a very good vocabulary, and I've only beat her once, and she laughs that she still beats me. And I'm a good speller, but anyway. Our knitting club meets every Wednesday at 6:30 in the fireplace room, so knitters of all levels are welcome. This is not a class. They're not there to teach you. It's just kind of a coffee clatch. They get together and teach each other. You know, if you need to know how to do a stitch, they'll help you, but it's not for someone to come in. You have to come to Miss Nancy's knitting class.
Or Miss Heather. I'm learning. I started a scarf. Miss Heather helped me.
Oh, Miss Heather's cat scarf. That would go great with my hat.
I've not seen her cat scarf. Oh, well, the one she's working on for her mom.
No, it was, actually she made it into an afghan, but when
I thought it was a blanket.
She made it into an afghan, but when I saw it, it was just, you know.
Oh, okay.
She's like, you'll love this. And I did. And I did. And the library, I was on Facebook the other night and somebody posted, and I don't remember if it was in a Bethel, must have been in like Citizens of Bethel Park, asking if there were any book clubs like in the neighborhood or online. Mm. And one of our staff members, Christine Gunther, replied, because I was getting ready to post. And I looked and I saw that she said, yes, indeed, the Bethel Park Public Library has 5 book clubs and new members are always welcome. So we have a Monday evening book club, that's Michelle and Ellen's, that meets the last Monday of each month at 7:30 p.m. in the fireplace room. We have a morning mystery book club that meets the second Wednesday of each month at 10 a.m. in the conference room. We have a evening mystery book club that meets the third Wednesday of each month in the conference room. Thursday evening book club meets the third Thursday of each month at 7, and the Thursday morning book club meets the last Thursday at 10 a.m.
Did you get all that?
Yeah, no, you didn't get
all the information is online.
It is on our website. And then there's also, we have a book club blog, so you can click there and see what next month's selection is. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you can come once, you can come every time. You know, if there's a book that interests you, that you would like to discuss with people, It's a good thing to do. So, yes, I'm still amazed at how many people don't know what the library has to offer. And I feel like
sad but true.
I fail. Like,
oh,
I feel
it's
like,
not
I feel
on
like
you.
That's all I talk about is library, 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 and what we offer. And I'm still amazed when people don't know what we offer.
There's just a lot of people. We live in a fairly large community.
We do.
There's just a lot of
32,000.
People that, you know, right.
Yeah.
So there's always going to be somebody that doesn't know what we offer.
It's very
and that's kind of exciting because we just get to keep
telling
people.
It's an opportunity, an opportunity. So with the big snow, you know, I had to, you know, we had our driveway paved finally, and we have a driveway that holds 9 cars. So 3 wide and 3 deep. So there was a lot. I'm not a shoveler, but.
I was out there for 20 minutes. I'm telling you, my back was hurting.
My back was killing me. I did the deck and the steps, and my back was killing me. Well, we have a snow blower, but all the things in our household are old and, you know, kind of just hung together. So I was like, I'm getting out the snowblower. So I got out the snowblower and I had a heck of a time with this big monster of a snowblower.
Yeah.
So I was like, that's it. I want a new snowblower.
Snowblowers are expensive.
They're incredibly expensive.
I didn't know. I was pricing them out for a Christmas gift for my boyfriend. I'm like, okay, he's not getting the snowblower this year.
So I was like, all right, well, what's the best model? What's this? So I was like, oh, Consumer Reports. So we have access to consumer reports online or through a database. So I made a little video about me trying to find the best snowblower. So check this out.
When you need to find something from Consumer Reports, you can go to the library's website at bethelparklibrary.org. And then at the top, click on the e-resources tab and then on database search. You'll come to this landing page for all things e-library. So there's e-books, e-audio, magazines, and research databases. So I chose to go to Consumer Report, and when you hover over it with your pointer, your mouse, you'll get a Go symbol. So you click on the Go, and it will bring you to the Consumer Reports landing page. And you type in your search term, in this case, snowblowers, and it brings back a list. Now, I know for my husband that I'm looking at for a two-stage gas snowblower, so I clicked on that, and it brought me a list of two-stage gas snowblowers. And then I wanted to look at one of the highly rated ones. So I looked at the Toro Power Max, and in there, you can see a rating scorecard for what it does well and what it doesn't do too well. And then you can figure out what features you want and what isn't important to you. And when you're done, just click back to the library's homepage and see what other cool things the library has to offer.
So yeah, great resource, great reminder that we have access to that.
Yes, because frankly, I was like, I need Consumer Reports, but I'm at home. And I'm like, oh, wait, we have
it's online.
We have access to it. So yes, a reminder to all. There's, you know, a lot of our resources are available through our website too. So even if we're closed, like we were closed that day, I was still able to access the information through our website. So
did you purchase a new snowblower? Not yet.
No, my goodness, no. The one that Bill said that we should get is $800, and I'm just not prepared to spend that right
crazy.
Now.
Crazy.
So I'll struggle with the big monster snowblower that's old and difficult. But
yeah.
So what's going on over your way?
So over in our department, it's kind of opposite the way we do winter reading, not the way we do it so much as the time that we do it. So our winter reading club is actually winding down. But just a reminder to any of you guys who did participate, we're having our winter reading celebration the last Sunday of this month, so the 30th, at 2 p.m. So come celebrate with us. We'll have some activities, and I think we'll play bingo, and we'll just celebrate all of your reading efforts. And of course, we'll pull the winners to those 6 raffle baskets upstairs the following day on February. We'll probably do it, we'll do it February 1st, and we'll notify you via phone call or email if you are indeed a winner.
Those baskets are awesome.
Yeah, well,
really
the stuffed animals that are in there were handmade by a volunteer. You saw them. So adorable.
I did, but I forgot.
Yeah, we put
them.
A couple of those in the basket.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, so we're excited about them this year. During the month of February, we are on break as far as our regular story time schedule classes go, but those will resume in March, and our new spring flyer is due out very soon, so you can look for that online or pick one up in person. But you know, just as a reminder, we run on an eight-week cycle. So we started story time in December. It was December, January. We take February off. We start again March, April. We'll be off in May. We start again June, July. So that's kind of how our story times run. So there are no weekly story times in February, but we are offering STEAM in stories Friday mornings at 11 every Friday in February. And you know, it's never too early, I don't think, to introduce children to those STEAM concepts. And when we say STEAM, of course, we mean science, technology, engineering, art, and math. Mm-hmm. I mean, kids are naturally curious.
Yes.
So we actually should be starting them when they're really young in a very simple way, introducing those concepts. So topics will include weight, sound, engineering, and space. And Miss Nancy has a lot of fun stories along with coordinating activities already planned and ready to go. So sign up for that. We are still having registration, and registration is limited due to social distancing, and we're still following COVID protocols. So if you are interested, you want to make sure you sign up early. Registration will begin on February 1st. We're also having a STEM play day Saturday, February 19th from 11 to 2. So this is just like a drop-by program. But again, if you're interested in science, technology, engineering, and math, you'll have an opportunity to just stop by, and we'll have all of our STEM, I guess you call them toys and materials, just kind of out, available for you to kind of explore. So we have things like Little Bits, right, and circuits, and we have a lot of, we're actually very fortunate, we have a lot of STEM-related materials
that
we want to start using more often. It's Saturday, February 19th.
Might have to have my nieces that weekend.
Yes, yep, and drop by anytime between 11 and 2 p.m. So there's, there is registration for that one. It's any age, but if you're bringing children 10 and under, you are required to stay with them. And then we're having another open art studio. You know, when the program room's available, we're trying to do this monthly because it has been so popular. And open art studios where you just have free access to all of our art supplies. We kind of open those craft closet doors, and there's just a plethora of craft materials in there, and you have access to most of them, and we save a lot of our recyclables, right? And so you can really get creative. We just put everything out there, and you get to come and create. There are no guidelines, there are no examples, there are no rules. Mm-hmm. You just get to come and make art. So if you're interested, the next one is February 9th at 6 p.m. And again, you register the first of the month. You can do that by hopping online or by giving us a call, or shooting us an email. Mm-hmm. On Monday, February 28th, we have a Tinkercad class. So if you have a child that's interested in 3D printing, this is a class for him or her, because this is kind of like the basics, because this is the start of how you learn to 3D print, right? Tinkercad is the software, the program that we use to make those cool 3D models. So you'll learn all about Tinkercad and how it works, and then once you're comfortable with it, you can kind of create a piece, and then Miss Beth will print your piece for you, and you can come pick it up at a later date.
And on that note, we are
new 3D printer
we're
coming.
Getting a new 3D printer. It is stuck out.
Yeah, I heard. Same thing happened with my furniture, right?
Supply
Hopefully, we don't have to wait
issue.
As long.
I know. Well, we do have. We still have our old
right.
3D printer that right. works, but we invested in a new one, and are turning the old reference office into.
Yes, it's exciting.
Into a STEM room?
Mm-hmm. And you gave us the okay, so we moved all of our stuff up there in the filing cabinet last night, actually.
Yes, and I actually do have, the door will be locked unless we're using it because there's expensive equipment in there. But so it'll all be in one place.
Yeah,
and
which is nice.
I'm really excited about it.
Yeah, so. Me too. For our teens, we are offering a math lab for the first time ever. So Thursdays in February, you can drop by after school anytime between 3 and 5. You don't need to make an appointment. And Ms. Megan will be there on hand to answer your questions, review homework with you, help you study for a quiz. And I'm just super excited about this because
God
I think it's a great, you know, tutoring.
Someone that can do math.
Right. Amen to that because it's certainly not me. But also, you know, just knowing, like, I myself struggled mm-hmm. all throughout middle school and high school, and tutoring can be expensive.
Oh, very.
So we're offering you free tutoring. You know, and I can't guarantee that it'll be one-on-one because it depends on how many people will drop by, but we'll be over in the teen lounge, and Megan will certainly be able to, like, assist all of you and kind of just hop from student to student offering whatever kind of help and advice is needed. So please take advantage of that. Again, Thursdays in February from 3 to 5 p.m. There's only one that last Thursday. We don't have it. So it's the 3rd, 10th, and 17th, but we will be continuing it in March as well. And then, you know, Valentine's Day lands on a Monday this year. Mm-hmm. And who doesn't want to be pampered on Valentine's Day, right?
Is this the teen spa day?
Teen spa day. I want to come.
I want to come too. I want a facial.
So you'll learn some beauty hacks and make a few new products to take home. There will also be a complimentary and optional, it's if you're comfortable, you know, with it, but we'll do manicures and face masks.
I want a mask.
I know. So take advantage of that at 6 p.m. Bring a friend. We do have to sign up just so we make sure we have enough materials handy. This is anybody in grades 7 and up. Again, Valentine's Day at 6 p.m. And then I just want to talk about another cool opportunity for kids in K through 3rd, I believe, this year. The WQED Annual Writers Contest. One of my favorite things, really, that I usually get to help out with. They've asked me in the past to be a judge.
Yes.
And so I get to go down to the WQED studio and read all of these wonderful stories from kids, not only in this area, but all throughout Allegheny County. And I am always just so impressed with not only the story itself and, like, the lesson. A lot of times there's, like, a lesson or a mm-hmm. message. But the illustrations are always so fantastic. So it's one of my favorite things. And this year, they're switching up a little bit. It is only open to K through 3rd, where I think it used to be
till 5th.
Fifth. And then it used to be you could write about anything you'd like. This year there's actually a theme, and they want you to write about your future. So I have this poster here.
I like a theme.
Well, it does help, like, if you have writer's block.
It's a prompt.
It's a starting point. Yeah. Right. And you could still get so creative with that, right, and take that in many different directions. But that's the theme, right? The future. And so it's running right now all the way through March. And if you want more information, of course, visit their website. They have all the information there on pbskids.com. But you can visit our website as well or stop in and see me. We have some bookmarks and some like promotional materials, some things to help you get started, like writing prompts and such. And I just think it's so much fun. It's a great opportunity. So. We've had many winners in the past from Bethel Park, and I thought maybe if there was time, I can actually share a short story.
That'd be great.
One of the past winners. Would you like to do that? Okay, so this is from my buddy, Harris Wanus, back when he was in third grade, or second or third grade, and he is now at Neil Armstrong.
Oh,
believe it or not, time flies. But he wrote this story called The Fish Who Had a Wish. And check it out. I love how he put the PBS logo in there, and he did a pretty good job, like, copying it. And so it goes like this. My name is Finney. I want to tell you something horrible that happened once in my life and how I solved it. It started when I was born. When I was a baby, I thought that the oceans were supposed to be dirty and it was supposed to rain trash. I didn't think that was right. So you can see this is a story about pollution, right?
Yes.
It has a very important message. Then, when I was about 2, I saw a huge creature dropping a trash can into the water, and I learned that it was dirty because people were littering. My friends at school thought the trash was a free treat, and they were getting really sick when they ate it. Illustrations here are great. There's like a fish nurse and a fish doctor. So, I thought of a plan. First, I found a scuba diver. Next, I tried to be funny so he would follow me. And then I had to find the spot with the most trash. After that, I wrote, "Help us," in the sand with my fin. Finally, the scuba diver cleaned up some of the trash. Then he went back up to the land and told his friends about the trash. And his friends told their friends, and everyone soon started to help clean up the oceans. Finally, my friends felt better, and the oceans were clean again. The end. So an important message there, right? We can't be throwing our... And how often do you see that? Like, even at the beach and stuff, you see litter everywhere, and it's...
It's very sad.
It is very sad.
You bring it, take it back with you.
Exactly. It's simple. So, cute little story that was a third place winner back in, I think this was 2019. 2018, again, from our local friend, Harris Wanus. Wow. So that's the QED Writers Contest.
That's a really great, I like that. I'm glad kept it.
And it has been going on for quite a while because my son Robert participated back when he was like in first grade, right? So it has been going on for a while and good thing because I think it's too good of a project to...
And how exciting. How exciting for a young person to be published.
Yes. Yeah, that's the other thing. You get published in all of the participating libraries. I think all of the libraries maybe get a copy to catalog and have in their system. So you're like, yeah, the winning stories are out there.
Yeah.
You are a published author. So
very cool. Yeah.
I also just want to mention our annual CCAs. That's the Children's Choice Awards, another project that's near and dear to my heart. This is the 10th anniversary.
Oh, my word.
I know. So we wanted to, like, go big. But unfortunately, just due to, like, timing and just this, you know, the last 2 years have been so crazy,
honestly. You never know from one week to the next
what the
positivity rate's going to be.
Right. So we're not offering a big in-person event like we have in years past, and we're not offering the incentives really that we used to, but we are still definitely promoting the books. Every year there's 8 books that are chosen, selected for the contest. You are encouraged to read as many as you can and then vote for your favorite one. I reached out to the winning authors of previous years, and I actually heard back already from a few.
Really
so we're
cool.
trying to put together like a little video montage of all of the winning authors, again, from the last 10 years. And their messages have been neat, right? They are just so honored to have their book be a winner.
Yes.
And they also kind of just encourage kids to keep on reading, because it is really cool that we are empowering you to vote for your favorite one. And we want you guys to kind of talk about the book and promote the book, and you create the buzz about the book. That's really important. You know, it's fun when adults do it, but I think it's even more important and more fun when it's like kids talking to kids, kids recommending to kids the other books. So anyway, once that video is complete, we will of course share it with all of you. But some of the books on this year's list include Karma Moon Ghost Hunter by a previous winning author, Melissa Savage. She won 2 years ago for her book Lemons, which was about Bigfoot. If you read that book and enjoyed it, you'll definitely want to check this one out. We always have a graphic novel on the list. This year's selection is Katie and the Cat Sitter. I've not read this one yet, but I'm anxious to. Oh, you might want to read this one, Katie and the Cat Sitter.
Back. I like the back with her with sitting with the kitty.
There's a cat on her head. That's, sound familiar?
It's my house. Cat on my head.
This one is Ghost Girl, which I am currently reading. It's very good. It's actually about a young girl who is being raised by her older sibling, and you know, the older daughter, you know, always has to work hard. She's hardly ever home, so a lot of times she makes her come along to the diner where she works. And the story starts with the opening chapter is her like begging her sister, "I really don't want to go to the diner with you again. I'm in sixth grade. Please, if you let me stay home, I promise I'll be good. I'll clean the house. I'll have dinner ready when you get home." And so the older sister, you know, relents and gives in and lets her stay home alone. And do you think she stays in and cleans the house?
Of course
and
she doesn't.
No, she immediately sneaks out to the graveyard, picks up her best friend Z first, and then they head to the local graveyard because this girl's kind of, I don't want to say obsessed, but she's very into ghosts and storytelling. That's her
thing.
I'm
going to have to read that. And so, do you know the difference between a graveyard and a cemetery?
Is there a difference? No.
There is.
What is it?
A graveyard is attached to a church. So there's a church, and then there, and a cemetery has no
I never knew
with
that.
See?
Learn oh, interesting. Yes, you do. Jennifer Holmes, another author I love. Her book, The Lion of Mars, made the list this year. Another one is Amari and the Knight Brothers by B.B. Alston. Maybe, Maybe, Marisol Rainey by Aaron and Trotta Kelly. The Elephant in the Room by Holly Goldberg Sloan. And Unplugged by the ever-popular Gordon Corman. So check some of those titles out, especially if you're in grades 3 through 6. They are like most appropriate for you. I know you'll enjoy them. You know, if we don't have copies here because they have been going out a lot, we can always request a copy and get one in for you from another library. So check out those books for sure. And I don't know, I guess that's about it.
I have one announcement that the library will be closed on Monday, February 21st, in observance of President's Day. This is new for us. We usually, in the past, have been open, but the municipality and their offices are closed and we don't have support. And to go the weekend, Saturday, Sunday, without support, and then Monday. So we will not be here. We will be closed. So that's all. That's all I have.
Great. Well, as always, thank you for joining us on this evening's show. If you have any questions about any of the things that we talked about, again, you know what to do. You can reach out to us by giving us a call.
Visit our website.
Or better yet, stop in and see us in person. Take care, everyone.